Mr. Liu from the Beijing Auto Museum, I'm really delighted to welcome you to the Best of Heritage 2020. Congratulations on winning a special award from the Chinese Association of Museums. First of all, could you tell me a little bit about your institution, which is so special?
Yeah, it's my pleasure to give you a brief introduction to Beijing Auto Museum. Yeah, Beijing Auto Museum is a government-funded non-profit museum. Its planning began in 2002, and it was complete and be opened to the public in 2011. It covers the floor areas about 50,000 square meters. The museum has a very modern shape from the top view, just like a bright eye. The meaning of the eye is to look to the past, present, and the future. But you know, automobile is the machine. It's regarded as the machine that changed the world and has great impact on human life. Based on our understanding, we plan our normal exhibitions from the perspectives of man, car, and society. In this way, we can break the restrictions of countries, regions, and the brands, and integrate the history of the world's automobile industry and the development of Chinese auto industry. By doing this, we can reveal the great impact of automobile on human civilization and the social progress. As a themed museum, our museum developed dozens of science and technology related exhibition items, so audiences here can see, listen, and experience the auto technology in an interesting way. We also arranged many learning drawings for children according to the features of the audiences. Based on our public welfare nature, we developed many kind of learning programs and activities. From the beginning to now, we have held more than 2,500 activities to the public, and there are more than 5 million audiences having their visit to our museum. Yeah, this is the brief introduction.
Thank you. That's amazing. Your visitor figures are incredible. I wonder if you could tell us now something about the prize that you won from the Chinese Association of Museums.
During the International Museum Day of 2019, Beijing Auto Museum stood out from China's over 5,000 museums and was recognized as the most innovative museum in China. I think the honor is owing to the following reasons. Firstly, Beijing Auto Museum is one of the museums that first started the application in service standardization in museum management in China. The original idea is to improve the public service quality and the management level. So we want to build a warm and vibrant museum. Without any examples, it took us 5 years to establish the service standardization system. And in 2016, the Beijing Auto Museum was recognized as the first national demonstration organization of service standardization in China's museum industry. Through the service system, our opening operation runs smoothly without any major safety accidents till now. Secondly, based on our automobile feature, our museum realized that the integration development of popular science, cultural story, and tourism. So we have developed many kinds of educational programs and some learning activities. In addition to looking around the museum, the audiences can attend the above mentioned activities. So your diversified demands will be met. In every year, our museum will receive more than 600,000 visitors, of whom 16% are students and 18% are children. Thirdly, our museum is still a young theme museum, and the average age of the staff members is 34. As you know, so we are so young that we can keep exploring the new development and providing the better service to the public.
Yeah. I guess you've hinted at this, but what particular qualities or innovations do you think really impressed the judges to give you this award?
For us, I think it mainly attributes to the innovation in service standardization. For our museum, there are nearly 500 staff members and more than 10,000 sets of equipment. How to make all these people work together efficiently, and how to make all the equipment run smoothly, and how to satisfy the need of the audiences. These are the questions we need to address. So in 2012, the second year after the opening, we began to establish our service standardization system. Based on the visiting routes of the audiences, we sought out the service items and the process and set up 5 service systems, such as visiting, catering, shopping, conference, and popular science and technology education. In accordance with the features of each service, we formulated the corresponding course manuals in detail. By now, we have established over 2,000 standards and covered all my staff members of the museum. Because of our practical results in museum service standardization, Beijing Auto Museum played a leading role in drafting the service norm for the local museums in Beijing. At the same time, we also published the relevant books in service standardization and spread the experiences to boost the development of the museum industry. Of course, we also wish if have the opportunity to work together with the museum around the world and promote the research of the museum service standardization.
Well, congratulations. Yes, wonderful collaborative work. I'm sure that it wasn't all plain sailing. Can you tell us maybe some difficulties that you experienced during your project?
For this question, I think, in fact, at the beginning of the construction, we were faced with the questions of how this art museum should be positioned. Different from any other art museum around the world, set up either by companies or by private collectors. Beijing Auto Museum is a government-invested non-profit museum. How to consider the brand, the region, and the relationship between China's automobile industry and the world's automobile industry? These are all issues we need to think about. Finally, we set our goal to build it a Chinese-based, international-oriented art museum. The Beijing Art Museum is only about automobile industry itself, and the peoples and the events behind it, as well as the products and the development trends of the industry. We follow a subject selection approach based on the science, technology, and the society, and present them in topics such as the stories of the auto industry in over 100 years, and the technological changes and the relationship between automobile and the cities, and so on. We talk about the development of the Chinese automobile industry in the context of the world automobile industry as a whole. Meanwhile, we work to highlight our public welfare nature of our museum and make efforts to build our museum into a culture center, a learning center, and a civic activity center. And that positioning also lays a good foundation for our museum to give a full play to the public welfare function. After 9 years of open operation, the Beijing Auto Museum has been recognized and praised by all sides.
I've seen some wonderful photographs of small children really enjoying your museum, but the photographs were just of boys. So could you tell me if you have a program that particularly appeals to women or girls?
Mm-hmm. In our museum, the most impressive collection related to women is Ban's patent car. This car was patented on January 29th, 1886, a day marked the birth of modern cars. This car is closely linked to Bertha Benz, wife of Carl Benz, the inventor of the Benz patent car. At the beginning, the public was not much interested in this rolling and sticking machine. And they had no idea about its operation principle, so they called it wizard wagon, and let alone riding with it. But Bertha Benz was very confident of this new machine. In the early morning, in August 1888, without telling Benz, Bertha Benz took her two sons and drove the car her husband invited to visit the grandmother of their children in Pforzheim, a city over 100 kilometers away. In spite of the trouble along the way, after a whole day's driving, they reached the destination and finished the first long-distance road test for cars in human history. After this trip, Bertha Benz became the first person of the long-distance driving. Bertha Benz, who knew little about the machinery in the cars, showed the critics at that time that the car was stable enough for everyday use. In the 130 years of automobile development, the participation of women has promoted the innovation of automobile technology and the progress of the automobile industry. There are so many excellent female designers, engineers, entrepreneurs, and researchers. It can be said that women really had made great contributions to the entire automobile industry.
Well, one of my interests are in art and design, and I wondered if there was some special active art and design learning programs that you're really proud of, that you might outline for us now.
Yeah, for this question, I think automobile design is one of the important components of the Beijing Auto Museum a permanent exhibition of car design is set up in our museum. We have held many design-themed learning activities and themed exhibitions in this regard. Now, let me take the Green Power China as an example. It's a green energy electric vehicle project. This is an innovative learning program for teenagers. Team members were required to design, build, and test a single-seater electric vehicle. After the vehicle was built, they also needed to take part in the static graduation and dynamic field competition. According to the rules of the competition, students can be creative in using different materials in design and build the shell of the electric vehicle. Some use the ultralight wooden material and some use waste materials to convey their concept of environmental protection. In the process of designing and manufacturing electric vehicle, the required students to apply the science, technology, engineering, mathematics, and art, and the other disciplines, which fully reflects the concept of STEAM education. This kind of exploratory learning and team raising can inspire the young people creative spirit and help them to explore their infinite potentials. At the same time, students can be encouraged to learn how to solve the problem faced by today's society, especially in the field of sustainable development, and think about how to make the design more ecological and environment friendly in the future. We have cooperated with more than 10 primary and secondary schools to carry out this project. The students, teachers, and parents gave very high valuation to this project. And we hope to make our museum a popular learning center through this project.
Well, thank you very much. It was wonderful to talk to you today, and I can't wait to come to visit your museum. I think your programs are really rich and very complex, and they will appeal to young children as well as older people like myself. So thank you very much for talking to me today, and I wish you all the very best with your future projects, which are so important for our planet.
Thank you for your interview today. Look forward to your visit to our museum.